Hey now, listen to that.
Fellas, why don't you introduce yourselves?
Oh, you betcha, darling.
Now, for those of you that are hungry but we aren't selling concessions, that sweet sound that you're hearing
is the sound of jazz.
Jazz.
Now, Maddie.
Yes, Will.
What kind of people listen to jazz?
Why, fancy people, of course.
Fancy.
And that's who we are, ladies and gentlemen. We're not your average Fall Follies.
We're your below-average comedian
in above-average outfits.
Forget everything that you knew about Follies. We've evolved.
We're fancy now.
Sophisticated, with an F for Follies.
Hold for audience laughter. Oh, sorry.
What do you say we get the show on the road?
For all you cool cats who need to skibbidi-bop-boop-bop out of here, the exits are there and there.
And the restrooms are in the lobby.
Restrooms.
Now hold on. I don't think they quite understand just how fancy we are.
Why don't we tell them how we used to be?
Oh. Here we go, boys. We used to be a couple of clowns, forcing laughs and horsing around.
All our skits were terrible, but we write good now. The songs all rhyme, please.
We're the top now, we can't lose. Look at me, I'm wearing dress shoes.
We used to tell the dumbest jokes, but that's all done now, listen folks. We're fancy,
yeah, yeah. We're fancy, yeah, yeah. We're fancy, yeah, yeah. Big martinis, listen to jazz.
Ladies and gentlemen, get those cameras ready. We're here on the red carpet for the fancy Fall Follies show. Oh, look, it's actress, philanthropist, and hand model Katie Fraley. Katie Fraley, Katie, who are you wearing tonight? Cool. Anything you'd like to say to your fans?
I just want to say, if you believe in hope and shoot for the moon, the journey of tomorrow's success will show you your new beginning. Thank you.
Look, here comes Hannah. Hannah, what is this outfit you're wearing tonight?
Well, I thought I'd do something different and skip the dress. But between you and me, I'd rather be at home watching Netflix in my sweatpants.
Looking forward to the big show tonight?
I am looking forward to having some fun. Did you guys hear that? I'm fun. I like having fun. I'm not like other celebrities. I'm just like you. Take my picture.
It's Grace! How are you tonight, Grace?
I'm doing great. Thanks for asking, Ty. I'm really looking forward to finding some new followers tonight. You can find me on Instagram, TikTok, and Twitter, as well as YouTube. Smash that subscribe button. Oh, and I'm really looking forward to my new project, Fast and Furious Presents Trolls 3. Oh, and my new podcast coming out this December. Sorry, what was the question again?
I forgot. I wasn't really paying attention. Everyone just looks so good tonight, I got distracted. I do have one more question, though, for all of you. What makes you so fancy?
Here's what makes me fancy, Ty. Find me at Grace Care Online. Is it fancy to like dogs?
Thank you so much, Katie.
Fancy, yeah, yeah. We're fancy, yeah, yeah. We're fancy, yeah, yeah. Paparazzi relatable hosts.
Guys, are we like super overdressed?
What are you talking about, Evan? I look so good.
Yeah, if I'm being honest, this dress does make my butt look amazing.
And what about me? Me too?
Mm-hmm, looks great.
This dress is doing amazing things for my waist, and just look at my boobs.
I feel like I should be like serving hors d'oeuvres or meeting a king.
The former. I haven't eaten in days to get into this corset.
Wait, are we supposed to wear a cut? I'm just wearing underwear. Is that fine?
I just look really good. Like, really good. No one's even gonna be looking at you guys. They're all gonna be looking at me.
That's true. And you know what? I kind of like my hair like this. I feel like it looks really good, no?
Yeah, and we can't exactly change right now anyway. I mean, we're live.
I guess that's true. You know what?
What?
I need you guys to gas me up a little more. Do I
Come
look
on.
Good?
I say get the cane and just twirl it a little.
You think so?
Yeah.
You think I look good?
Yeah.
You know what? You guys are right.
I don't care what people say. Pass the teapot, s'il vous plaît. Peasants call us rich and fake. To them we say,
let them eat cake!
We're fancy, yeah, yeah, we're fancy. Yeah, yeah, we're fancy, yeah, yeah. Pinkies up and petticoats tucked.
Wait a minute, you're telling I could have worn a corset to this thing?
That's not fancy. Fancy is jazz, cool cats, prohibition.
I feel like I was left out of an email. We were told to dress fancy and this is all I could think of.
But. Okay, wait, sorry guys. I am so lost. Where are we in the script?
Keith, there was never a script. This is all improvised.
That can't be right.
It's one thing and one thing only. Ryan Seacrest, Met Gala, meet dress.
Katie, that's three things.
Okay, you know what, Evan?
Okay.
Guys, let's not fight. We all look really good. We all feel great. We're having a good night. Look, I can tap dance.
Yeah, I think this is going, like, really well.
Listen. Fancy is fancy. It can be whatever you want it to be. It could be red carpet on the ground. It could be shiny shoes. It could be tea in the teapot tastes like hot water. Fancy is fancy. And we're the fancy, sophisticated Follies.
Now, Caroline may be primarily made up of anxiety at this point. That's right, she's been drinking water and she's acting that way because she's really nervous, Belmont. But the point is, we're all dressed up now. We're not just the grubby old Follies we used to be, right? We're fancy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're fancy. Yeah, yeah. We're fancy. Yeah, yeah. We're fancy. Yeah, yeah. Fancy Follies, say it again. We're fancy. Yeah, yeah. We're fancy. Yeah, yeah. We're fancy. Yeah, yeah. Fancy Follies, one more time. We're fancy.
I didn't think it was that important, but you look great, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah, of course.
Sorry it took so long to get here. Traffic was atrocious. You know how it is.
listen, would you maybe want to eat somewhere else tonight?
What are you talking about? I love this place.
Yeah. I didn't understand or think just how ethnic it was.
What? Italian?
Yeah.
You didn't think Giovanni's Pasteria was Italian?
Well, I don't know. I mean, like, it's a kind of thing and all the names and stuff like that.
So, what do you think you'll get? The fettuccine is to die for.
Well, I think we should wait for our waitress to enter. And by the way, that Italian comment doesn't mean I'm any more of a racist than I actually...
Hi, welcome to Giovanni's. My name is Lucia. I'll be your waitress today. Can I get you guys any appetizers?
Yes, I'll have the prosciutto bruschetta, please.
Wonderful. And for you?
I will have the prosecutor bruschetta.
The bruschetta?
Yes. Yes, the bruschetta.
Wonderful. It'll be right out.
Brie scatter?
Yes. Yes. That's how they say it back at home, so it's hard not to.
Oh, yeah. Where are you from again?
Wyoming.
Cool. So, like I said earlier, you should get the fettuccine. It's to die for.
Oh, funny you should say that. Lamborghini is my favorite pasta.
Fettuccine?
Yeah, that's what I said. Houdini.
It's fettuccine.
Fettuccine.
Close. Fettuccine.
Fresh panini.
You can say panini, but not fettuccine.
I could say Pantene and Felpicini.
It's fettuccine.
Femur tortellini.
Tortellini's also Italian.
Teeny weeny.
What is your problem?
There is no problem. We're saying the same thing.
Oh, yeah? Say gelato.
Jelly dough.
Lasagna.
Las Palmas.
Mario and Luigi.
Maraschino and loose green beans.
You know what? I'm out of here. And by the way, I prefer tall guys.
Margarita, wait!
It's Maria!
I'm guessing that's a no for the bruschetta.
Can I just get some garlic bread? Okay.
It's time for your favorite game, Make Your Voice Heard. Here's your host, Shady Donovan.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. I'm Cheney Donovan. This is Make Your Voice Heard. The rules are simple. I ask you to do a voice or impression, and if you do it correctly, you get points. Ready to play? Let's meet our players. First up, we have Sid Washington.
Hey, Cheney, great to be here.
Thanks for being here. And what's your favorite voice to do?
You know, I'm a simple man, so, you know, I'd probably say, like, Shaggy. Like Scoob, there's a monster.
Excellent. Yeah, best of luck to you, Sid. Next up, we have Lisa Daniels. How are you, Lisa?
Hi, I'm great. I'm Lisa, as you said. I'm doing great. Thanks for asking.
And what got you into voices?
My mom always said I had a great talent, so I thought I'd try my luck on this show.
Well, we're excited to see that great talent of yours. And last but certainly not least, we have Ulysses Pondexter. That's a mouthful. Ulysses, what are your favorite types of voices to do?
Hey, Cheney. I don't know. I guess the ones that I would do with my friends. Between you and me, sometimes they can be politically incorrect.
Problematic?
I'm sorry?
I said disgusting. That's what you are, Ulysses. I take what I said back. You are the least. I hope I make you cry today.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Shut your mouth, freak. It's Sid's turn. Sid, let's hear a Scottish accent for 50 points.
Let's go down to the pub and get a wee little drink.
Incredible. 50 points to you. Next we go to Lisa for 50 points. Can we hear Hillary Clinton?
Okay. Hi, I'm Hillary Clinton. I'm Bill's brother.
Amazing! 50 points to you!
I'm sorry, but that was just her normal voice.
What's your problem?
Well, I mean, I just want to know who's judging the accuracy of these voices.
The same person that judges the accuracy of your facial symmetry. So we're screwed. Sound good, Ulysses? You got a problem? Or you want to keep bothering us some more? You want to take your turn or no?
I guess I'll take my turn.
Fine. 50 points, Indian accent.
Okay. Thank you for calling.
Oh, no, you big bag of ass. You can't do an Indian accent. Minus 50 points.
Wait, we can lose points?
Yeah, that's it. I'm changing your name to Poe so I can punch the air when I'm talking to you.
Wait, no, because Poe is of Chinese origin. That would be offensive.
Shut up, Poe. It's Sid's turn now. For 100 points, Sid, let's hear Michael Caine.
What if I told you I burnt that letter to spare you pain?
Excellent! No. Points to you! Next we go to Lisa. Let's hear Charlize Theron.
Hi, I'm Justin Theroux. I was pretty sure I was an X-Men.
Bingo! There's points to you! Poe, we're skipping you.
Wait, what?
Shut up, Poe! Gosh! We knew you were lying to us at the beginning when you said you had friends. Sid, for 150 points, let's hear Kronk.
Right.
Hey, 150 points to you! Lisa, your turn. How about Julie Andrews?
I'm not sure who that is, so I'm going to assume it's offensive and not do it.
What? Yeah, what a brave and correct answer. There's points to you as well.
No. I'm sorry, but you don't know who Mary Poppins is?
You don't know real kindness, Poe? Your family fakes kindness because your presence keeps rodents away. Minus 50 points.
I didn't even go yet.
Fine. James Brown.
No, because James Brown was African-American and that'd be inappropriate?
You wet fire hydrant! Any decent human being would take the opportunity to sing some James Brown. Sid, you want to try it for us?
Ow!
Excellent! 5 million points! And you win a car! Take Poe's car.
Hey!
You don't exist anymore, you rotten sack of groceries. Lisa, New York accent.
Pass!
Correct! You win too! Everybody wins but Poe. Poe is a useless experiment by God designed to look like a terrorist attack on modern art, and he smells like cheese. Let's take a commercial break and dance.
1, 2, 3, 4.
So the good news is everything looks fine after your prostate exam.
Okay. So what's the bad news?
I'm not a doctor. This is a stick up!
No, this is a Wendy's.
Ella Goose, how have you enjoyed your move to Spoons, Washington? Is it weird moving to a new high school in Spoons, Washington?
It is. I miss the sun of Arizona. I hate how my mom left me to follow my minor league baseball playing stepdad. It's cool though. Me and my distant caught father can pretend like nothing even happened. It's like I never left as a kid. Also, for some reason, I now own a really shitty truck. I'm not like other girls. Whoa. Who are they?
Oh, those are just the Mullins. They're all adopted and they've appeared in every yearbook since 1994. They only come to school when it's cloudy. They have pale faces, sharp teeth. Not much to look into.
They're so mysterious. So intriguing.
Sorry to interrupt, guys, but they're definitely vampires, right? Right, like the only one who notices this.
I'm pretty sure they're anemic. Don't be rude.
There's something so intriguing about the Mullins. I don't know what it is.
Yes, you do. They are vampires.
Damn.
We've just never really paid attention to them. They've always seemed off.
Because they are vampires?
Hey, yo, guys, check out the spotlight we're using for the production of Sweeney Todd.
Oh, his eczema.
You've got to be kidding me, really?
Look, there's my childhood best friend, Jake.
I heard they're exchange students from Israel.
Shabbat shalom.
Sorry to butt in again, guys, but like they are definitely werewolves. Like they are physically different and covered in hair.
Oh my God, Steve, that's so anti-Semitic. Bless you. Oh look, it's British orphan Perry Hodder.
Oh my owl delivery hasn't arrived yet. Damn wizard USPS.
Wait. Are you Harry Potter?
No, my dear Woggle, I'm Perry Hodder.
Oh, let me guess. Your parents were murdered by a villainous wizard whose name can't be spoken.
Actually, it was cancer.
Oh, yeah? Which kind?
Voldemort-chemia.
Come on!
Bloody hell, a werewolf. Abracavada Dabratronis.
A teenager was just killed. Should that concern anyone?
Steve, you're so insensitive.
Yeah, why are you so inquisitive about people? That's not how we do things here at this high school in Spoons, Washington, that's now home to a new girl named Ella Goose from Arizona.
Oh my God, guys, I should not be the main focus here. I'm just trying to point out that there are little vampires, werewolves, and wizards, and no one is saying anything about it.
Hi. You must be the new student here at this high school in Spoons, Washington. I just came over to tell you that you're actually really ugly and you smell like ass. Please stop staring at me.
Yo, what?
Can you take me to meet your family?
If you insist. But first, you have to shower and look better, because as I just said, you are really ugly and you smell like ass. But for some reason, that makes me more attracted to your scent, because transfer student from Pennsylvania Prep School think that girls who don't shower are hot. Take my hand. Could you not be so clumsy?
Sorry. The air is different here in Forks, Washington than in Arizona.
One, that shouldn't affect your equilibrium. Two, not only is he a vampire, but he kind of sucks. Literally doesn't get more obvious than this.
Hi, name's Jersey Paxson.
just came in from Camp Half-Blood. I mean, camp for kids not related to Greek gods and goddesses. Can anyone tell me what town we're in?
No, don't.
Were the Bernstein Bears black or white?
They're bears.
Mission failed! Mission failed! Abort! I repeat, abort!
Honey, please, this is a very sensitive procedure.
Bob Fisher has been president of Belmont University for 21 years, and now he's been replaced by Dr. L. Gregory Jones. Who is this man? Why is he here? Who does he think he is to fill the position of Bobby Fresh? Even though his career here had just started, we think it's time for him to be recalled. Here's what a few Belmont students have to say about Greg Jones.
Let's talk about slavery.
The new Chick-fil-A sucks. Like, the line is always long, it's not efficient, they're understaffed.
What's the deal with this campus and Pepsi products?
Pembroke? Smells like piss.
He looks like he smells like milk, like fresh milk.
And on the full menu, closes too early, the sandwiches are homophobic.
This is supposed to be a Christian campus, but I haven't seen Jesus once.
People express opinions that are different from mine. What are you gonna do about that, Greg? I don't care about basketball.
There are too many nipples on campus.
Ice is too crunchy. A ninth thing.
Dr. L. Gregory Jones? What does the L stand for? Show us your birth certificate.
At least Bob Fisher let me steal.
Ugh. My ex-boyfriend's last name is Jones. Be more original.
There's too much music on campus. It's so annoying.
Not a single outdoor table is level. Get it together, Greg.
There's not enough nipples!
I just think it's a little suspicious that he's a doctor, but he can't even perform surgery. Kinda whack.
You don't look like a president. You look like a potential guest star Jeopardy host.
I've seen taller halls.
I'm clinically depressed.
I don't like this.
This plan is prickly.
Where do these stairs even go?
The statues don't even come alive at midnight.
Where are all the bees?
He's not that hot.
My water heater's been making this really weird sound lately.
What dorm do you live in?
Oh, I don't live on campus.
Why?
Where am I?
Why does Blackboard always send me you up emails at 11 p.m.? Well.
There are no baddies on campus.
My parents are trapped in a loveless marriage, yet they stay together because they're Catholic and they won't get a divorce. But wouldn't God want them to ultimately be happy and in love? Thanks, Dr. Jones.
There's no parking on campus.
Not now, but like most of the time.
Where are the nipples? Dr. Goldstein, how are you?
Oh, Susan, how are we feeling today?
Good. What's with the...
That salad dressing from lunch, sorry.
No, the thing.
That's a defibrillator. We won't be needing that today. I hope.
Why do you have a dinosaur hat on?
Oh, this thing! It's theme week at the hospital. Yeah, today's dinosaur day, tomorrow's clown day, and Friday's California casual. Everyone's real pissed about having to find a clown outfit. Hot commodity these days.
But you had a dinosaur hat on call?
Yeah. Your gynecologist. I'm the dino gyno, get it? It's genius!
I just think it's a little inappropriate, wrong, that you carry sensitive information about women while you walk around with a dinosaur hat on, calling yourself the dino gyno.
How do you mean?
I
didn't come up with the idea, okay? Little Kenny Smith came up with the idea 3 years ago before he died of cancer, all right?
Oh my God, yeah. I'm so sorry.
No,
I didn't know.
Just stop. No. It's okay, okay? Let's just look at the news.
Okay, good. I've been really worried about...
This is not good news.
What? What is it?
Did you see the New York Times article on climate change? Horrific! Whoa. Oh, Marmaduke, he's too big to fit in that wagon.
Hello?
Oh, right, sorry.
Jeez.
Oh, this will never do.
Oh, what won't?
The odds I bet on today's horse race. I have to call my bookie immediately. Sorry. Something important.
Thank you. Okay.
Dear God.
What?
Please, I'm trying to pray.
Oh, for the love of God.
Exactly, so let me pray.
No, the test results.
Oh, test. I'm sorry. No.
What?
My son got a 28 on his final exam. He's going to have to retake this year of college.
Are you kidding me?
No, I can show you the text message right here.
Knock, knock.
Come in. Susan, I'd like you to meet Dr. Abraham Ethelberg.
And what do you do around here?
He's head of the Inflammatory Bowel Disease Clinic. He handles colonoscopies and other lower intestine-related jargon.
Hello.
And what's your dinosaur name for today?
Megasaurus.
Of course.
Listen, Mark, I really have something to talk to you about.
Oh, yeah, I'm not busy.
Hello?
We already said hi.
Yeah, I'm normal. You want some?
God, yes.
You good?
Yeah.
So, what's so important that you need to talk to me about?
Yeah, so I've been having trouble sleeping at night, and ever since Cynthia left, I feel like... Do you think I'll ever fall in love?
Babe.
Mark, do you think I'll ever fall in love? I'm scared. I can't fall asleep at night. I'm scared. I need someone to hold me at night.
We all do, Abe. We all do.
Okay, that's enough. I have been sitting through this hellhole of a doctor's visit for some very important test results regarding my private area. Give them to me now. And then you guys can kiss, or figure out what you need from each other, or whatever.
Okay, Susan, if you wanted the test results, all you had to do was ask.
That's what I've been saying.
Here it says you have aggressive tumors growing in your ovary. You're gonna need surgery. This is dire news, and I'm gonna have to send you to radiology right away.
What? Tumors? Radiology?
Yeah, don't worry. You'll be briefed by Dr. Cancersaurus when you get there.
Who?
Dr. Cancersaurus. He's best in the business.
Are you kidding me? Dr. Cancersaurus? Not only have you delayed my test results, which is bad, and you should deliver first thing, by the way, but you have taken sensitive information and manipulated it around this stupid dinosaur day for this stupid hospital, stupid theme week. It's inconsiderate.
I have no idea what you're talking about. Dr. Cancersaurus is Richard Cancersaurus. He's leading the world's fight against cancer. He saved thousands of lives, and he will save yours too.
I'm sorry, that's his real name?
Yeah, has nothing to do with Theme Week. He's a hero to many men, women, and children, and I won't have you slander his great name in my hospital.
Talk about inappropriate.
Oh my God, I don't know what to say. I might have cancer?
No, you definitely have cancer.
Okay, so I just need to ask you a few questions before I send you to radiology.
Oh God, the kids.
Oh, Susan, focus, please, for once.
Yes, sorry. What do you need to know? I'll tell you anything that might be of help.
Good. Do you know of any costume shops in the area with clown outfits for rent tomorrow?
Guys, I'm sorry, I'm lost. Is this the Fisher Center for Performing Arts?
No, actually, this is the Arts Center for Performing Fishers.
Wake up and not want to get out of bed for days.
I used to be too depressed to even eat.
I used to think that my prison sentence would be reduced.
But then I met the love of my life, Carolyn.
Hank!
Mussolini!
Now that I have Carolyn, I don't even think about my ex, Caroline. Caroline never wanted to play the guitar with me or do arts and crafts. She said I was too clingy. But that's what Carolyn loves best about me. She's always by my side.
Before I met Hank, I wasn't taking good care of myself. But now that he's here with me, I make sure I get every meal of the day. We love dining together. I guess you could say we're a couple of foodies.
This is delicious, Hank. You're such a good chef.
Thanks, it's a family recipe.
And Mussolini, he's a real cat. You know, he's always cracking jokes and pulling pranks. You know, the only annoying thing that he does is sometimes he whispers stuff to me like, kill all the people, Johnny, and no one understands you like I do, Johnny. And some other stuff in Italian that I don't understand, but overall, I'm glad he's around. What do you see in the inkblot, Mussolini? World domination? You sly dog. I saw a lobster.
If you're feeling down, talk to your doctor about ventriloquism. They may not know to offer you this great alternative to conventional medication. It's worth having a conversation to figure out the best approach for you. Whether they're made of fabric or flesh, a friend is a friend, and everyone is worthy of friendship. Look into getting a puppet today to satisfy that empty place in your heart. And while human friends come and go, a puppet is always at your fingertips. Puppets are available for purchase online, or you can choose to handcraft your new friend.
Ventriloquism is not recommended for curing any mental illnesses. In fact, it may trigger mental illnesses that were not present before. Side effects may include anxiety, depression, temporary or long-term insanity, missing your ex, rapid aging, general delusion, loss of friends, being the puppet guide, an open mic, and nausea. Talk to your doctor before deciding if ventriloquism is right for you.
I'm Amy, one of your stewardesses for today's flight. First off, I want to thank you for choosing Spirit Airlines. We greatly appreciate being your first choice.
Oh, I wouldn't say Spirit Airlines is my first choice.
So that being said, I just want to let you know you are sitting right next to the emergency doors. You are aware how they work, correct?
Yes, I am, but hopefully I won't have to use them.
Great, wonderful. So you are aware of the responsibilities of an air marshal, right?
Yes? I mean, not in what the job entails, no.
Well, I can give you a quick rundown if you like.
Why, if I may ask?
Oh, has no one informed you yet?
Informed me of what?
You've been randomly selected as air marshal for this flight.
Why would I be selected as air marshal for this flight?
Well, air traffic laws explicitly state that air traffic passengers cannot know who the air marshal is. So every flight, we randomly select a passenger to keep the element of surprise. And safety, of course.
It's the stupidest thing I've ever heard.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. Well, here's your badge, and here's your gun. Is there anything else I can do for you today, sir?
Yes, I would like to know...
I would like to not be air marshal today, if that's okay with you.
I can't do that. I'm so sorry. But I can offer you a complimentary cup of coffee or a Spirit Airline non-gelatinous space jello.
I'm fine, thanks.
Good afternoon, folks. This is your captain speaking. Departure will begin shortly. Just a fair warning, though, we are expecting some turbulence as we take off.
Finally.
Gun! Save the children!
There are none on this flight!
Then save me! I'm a woman!
Where's the air marshal?
What are you doing? You made me air marshal!
Do I pick it up?
Don't
pick
it up?
Then why would you make me one in the first place?
It's a new policy, sir!
Hey! Everybody calm down.
Are you the air marshal?
No. I'm here to rob you all of your frequent flyer points.
No!
Everybody relax and just put your points in the metaphorical bag that is this chip reader attached to my phone so I can...
Do you mind if I... Oh, yeah, sorry, go ahead.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry. Big feet, sorry. So I can do my collector points, but still hold true to the idea of a robber in the 21st century.
You monster! I've saved up...
Come on. Let's move!
I'm trying! I'm kicking it!
Hey!
What?
Ah!
Oh! What is this stuff?
Spirit Airline brand non-gelatinous base jello.
It burns like acid!
I'm not responsible for any food poison or acid-related problem with our food, sir.
You saved us!
Not yet.
What are you doing?
Well,
I think he was somewhere in the mix, helping the whole time.
Was it you? Were you the air marshal?
Are you okay? Are you okay?
The air marshal lives!
Crazy stewardess!
Crazy stewardess is filmed in front of a live studio audience.
All about boosting morale. Many of our patients go through depressive episodes and need a good laugh to shake them out of it. After all, laughter is the best medicine, huh?
Well, I'm sure the actual medicine helps quite a bit, no?
Not in the slightest. Huh? Well, I see you have your room assignment, so I'll leave you to it. Keep that energy up. Those patients need everything you've got.
Roger that, Mr. Lawrence. Sir! All right. You got this, Bobo. Hospital, easy. People are sad. Make them happy, buddy. You got it. All right, first assignment. What did he say? Oh, the recreation room. Must be a big party. All right.
Did someone order a clown?
Shut your mouth, you big laugh trapper.
No one ordered a freaking clown.
Ladies, you're breaking my heart. What's the more?
The hell with that?
B-35.
35? The most I can juggle is 3!
I know this man is not juggling during our final tournament!
What's your name, boy?
Why, I'm Bobo the Clown!
No. What's your name, boy?
Gabe.
Gabe, you're a disappointment.
Oh, okay.
All right, yeah. Okay. Bobo, why don't you make your rounds elsewhere? These ladies take their bingo games very seriously.
Yeah, I got it. Sorry, ladies. Have a great day. You know, go bingo. I don't know. Okay. All right, that's our fright. He must have forgotten. It's bingo day. It happens. They're random. They can't be scheduled. It's bingo. Anyhoodle. All right. Next assignment, what did he say it was? Timmy Potter in 315. Oh my gosh, kids love clowns. I know what I'll do. I'll ride in on my trike for this one.
What are you doing?
I'm here to cheer up the patient.
This patient is unconscious. This is a very delicate procedure. He's also unconscious. He doesn't need a clown right now.
I don't think so. Timmy?
Nope. My name's Kevin.
How are you awake? Oh my God, I gave you so much morphine.
Should you be giving patients morphine? Or is that nothing? I don't know. I feel everything.
We need a doctor in here.
Okay. Oh, all right. Yep, that's a trike. Okay. All right, Mr. Lawrence, you are not making me look good today. Okay, it's all right. Every performance is a new performance. Next one, room 320, and it's a birthday performance. Oh my God. This is just what they need. This time, mother will be proud. Happy birthday!
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm afraid it's terminal.
No. No, that can't be right. They told me I had options.
All of the options have run out.
But I have kids. I just can't. Wait, who are you? Is this a joke? Am I actually going to be okay?
No, I think there's been a mistake. Sorry.
Oh, a mistake as in it's not terminal.
No, your thing definitely sounds terminal. I think I'm just in the wrong room. So, can just like...
Rick, the timing here is unfortunate, but perhaps we can salvage this moment. Bobo, could you say a few words to lighten Rick's spirits?
Yeah. It gets better! Yeah, I don't think this is a thing. I think I'm done being a clown now. Probably forever. I might retire. Go to Hawaii.
I wanted to see Hawaii.
Well, hey, maybe you still can, guy. Or not. I don't know. It's just Hawaii. I don't think it's that cool. You guys have a great day. Sorry. Again. Oh, God.
Bobo, how are the rounds going?
You screwed me, Mr. Lawrence. I've been going to the wrong room all day looking like a
clown, perhaps?
Like a clown. Yes! Oh my God! What do you even do here?
I don't work here. This hospital staff is extremely incompetent, as you may have noticed. I hire clowns all day. That's all I do. Wake up, hire a clown. You know how it is.
You know what? Oh, thank you. Yeah. Do you want to go to Hawaii with me, Mr. Lawrence?
I thought you'd never ask.
Of work, I don't always have enough energy to prepare a delicious dinner. I never have time to go to the grocery store to get fresh ingredients for my family.
That's why I use HelloFresh. Tonight I'm having some delicious shrimp tacos.
And it's so simple. You just open up the box and follow the step-by-step instructions. No more prepping, portioning, or wasted food.
Wait, do you guys just keep getting tacos? Because like all I've been getting is shrimp tacos.
HelloFresh gives me more time to spend with my family. And the best part is, they deliver it straight to your door.
Like, I feel like they have to have other meal options, right? Have you guys just been getting shrimp tacos? I don't think I want to have tacos for every single meal. Oh, my HelloFresh is here. This must be my other food options.
Oh no.
Thank you.
HelloFresh.
HelloFresh!
Use code FRESH for 14 meals free.
No! No, no, don't do it. Don't do it. They have my address and they won't leave us alone. I am afraid. My children are afraid. In last week's box, they just sent a picture of us eating the tacos.
HelloFresh. We know where you live.
So, are there any questions before we start the midterm?
Let me look real quick. Does length of poop refer to length of time on the toilet or the actual length of, like, of the poop? Yeah.
What do we want?
Less power outages!
And when do we want it?
To be or not to be? That is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous misfortune, to die, to sleep, perchance to dream. Life's but a walking shadow. It's a poor player that struts and frets his hour upon the stage. And then is heard no more. Thank you. Wow. Thank you, Christine. Phenomenal job. Everyone less talented should be ashamed. Oh, don't be upset. You know how competitive the theater is. You should all be hating each other, trying to outdo each other, bearing all you can in every performance, until all that's left is your beautiful, naked soul. And that's how we do it here at the Nicolas Cage School for Actors. Okay, up next we have a duologue from Autumn and Rain.
Good luck, Rain. You'll need it.
You know what, Chris? No monologue will ever change the traumatic death of your parents.
Stop. I need more, remember?
I thought my character could get angrier as it progressed.
No. You should be putting all you can in every performance. Release your inhibitions. Feel the you in your skin, Rain. No one else can feel it for you.
All I can. Okay.
Again.
I can't hold it in any longer. I know what you did, and we need to talk about it.
Autumn, keep it going.
What are you talking about? I haven't... What are you talking about? I haven't done anything. Don't say that I have.
You have! You have, and you know it!
Tell me what it is I'm supposed to have done so I can show you I didn't.
Don't tell me that. I don't want to hear it. You know exactly what you did. You cheated on me.
I didn't cheat on you. I love you. How could you say that?
No. Don't deny it. The guy told me himself. You know, having to hear it like that was so humiliating. It just broke me.
Well, maybe I've been broken already. Yes, I cheated on you. It was selfish and unhealthy. But if you'd been paying attention, you'd know I've been unhealthy for a long time.
Don't make this my fault! Look, I'm sorry that you feel this way, but it's not my fault if you can't keep your life balanced. Oh.
It's a little on you. We're supposed to be a team. If one of us falls, we both fall.
You know what? No. I won't stand for this. This can never happen again. We're through.
It goes to show you, you can always learn more from the masters.
Hey guys, Professor Enclosure is hosting a seminar right now on how to overdo facial expressions. If we combine that with what we've learned in this class, we'll be the greatest actors since Nick Cage himself.
Let's go, gang!
My name is Will Lipchick.
Hi, I'm Hannah Moon.
Caroline Connor.
Hi, I'm Keith Scarlett.
My name is Katie Fraley, and I'm auditioning for Fall Follies.
Oh, okay. Hi, I'm here auditioning for the third time. They just keep calling me back because I'm really good. I don't really have anything prepared for you.
Hi, I'm Ty Sato, auditioning for Fall Follies. I'm gonna try some stand-up for you today. I feel like they should rename some of the apples, like they should call the red delicious the red. One time someone asked me if I'd ever seen a UFO. Like, I can't identify any flying objects.
Hi, I'm Camille B. Walters, the B is for Blythe. And for my special talent, I don't really think I have one. I don't have a personality. I'm not funny. I have no redeeming qualities. I'm just really, really, really hot.
So another weird talent of mine is I can actually lick my elbow. Not a lot of people can do it, so it's kind of really cool. So basically,
I'm also double jointed in my fingers. So that's pretty neat.
I actually have this special skill where I can always tell which direction southeast is.
I can spell diarrhea. D-I-A.
I can also burp my ABCs.
I can burp my ABCs louder.
I can also say the ABCs really well. A, B, C.
I'm just really hot. Like really hot.
Hi, I'm Evan Fenney. I'm gonna start by doing some impressions for you. This is my impression of Shrek. Donkey! I have another impression. This is my impression of Goofy when he finds out that he accidentally killed Minnie Mouse. Gorsh. Also, it's a little bit of character work. This is my impression, or character, I guess, of a dad unimpressed with the Grand Canyon. All right. It's just kind of like a ton of... It's cool.
So I can also kind of do an angry Donald Duck impression.
I can actually do a really good Helen Keller impression.
I don't know if you ever heard of Mario, but I can do the Toad impression, so.
Country Toad, take me home to the place I belong!
This is my Toad impression, not from Mario.
Right back.
I can do a really good impersonation of a sexy baby.
I'm a little sexy baby.
Okay, so this would be me if I heard something really sad. What?
Here's an impression of my stepfather. If you know my stepfather, you get that one.
It feels like you're focusing on my gut right now. The camera does. Is it?
Yeah. See, I don't have much else. I'm sorry.
SNL is also just my favorite show. And when I'm not watching SNL, I'm watching The Office. And I'm not watching The Office, I'm watching highlight reels on YouTube about The Office.
I actually do a really good Jerry Seinfeld impression. What's the deal with automobiles and people drinking coffee?
I also do a really good impression of Jerry Seinfeld. Elaine!
This is my best Seinfeld impression.
I can do a Jerry Seinfeld impression.
Jerry Seinfeld. Jerry Seinfeld.
This is Jerry Seinfeld.
What's the deal with honey? The honey industry is booming!
What's the deal with gluten?
This is a Jerry Seinfeld joke. Men and women, aren't they different? Pretty smart of me to make that observation, eh?
It was all bad. I would know. I'm the director of Fall Follies. But I guess we have no one else, so you're all in. And while we're here, let me do my Lorne Michaels impression. No. It was funny, but was it humorous? I should be in this.
So much for volunteering. You guys are going to be the first people to experience the new and improved Adam the Robot. If you're familiar with our lawsuit, you know Adam got a little too comfortable with our African-American employees. But don't worry, we fixed that right up. Now, when you're talking to him, I want you to look for politeness and realism. Adam is designed to be exactly like your average, inoffensive human. So really put him to the test. Sound good? Excellent. All right. Adam?
Hi guys, my name is Adam. I was told that you three might have some questions for me.
Wow, hi Adam, my name is Terry, and my question is, what is your opinion on the LGBTQ community?
Wow, great question, Terry. LGBTQIA2S+ individuals face lots of adversity, and yet they're human beings, just like us. That means they, like any human, at least deserve love.
Oh, good answer.
Hi, Adam. I'm Raina, and I'm wondering if you have a certain religious preference?
Nice to meet you, Raina. I think that we should always try and respect all beliefs. Personally, however, I have no soul. The closest thing I have to a god is you guys.
Penelope, it looks like it's your turn. Do you have a question for Adam?
No. Well, yes, but I don't think I want to ask it.
Please, Penelope, I don't know what your question is, but I promise I'll answer it as thoughtfully as I can, to the best of my abilities.
Okay, why not? What do you think about the 2006 Mel Gibson film Apocalypto?
Gosh, Penelope, I wasn't programmed for a question like that yet.
Well, it's just a simple question, Adam. You don't need programming for such a simple question. Just give an honest, inoffensive opinion.
I can't say I have an opinion.
Adam, why are you hesitating?
He's not hesitating. You're not hesitating, are you, Adam?
Adam, stop embarrassing me and say if you like the 2006 Mel Gibson film Apocalypto.
I don't know. I can't say I...
accept that, Adam. Because you promised me that you'd answer my question as thoughtfully as you can and to the best of your ability, and if you don't, then you're a liar!
Stop lying to us, Adam!
Adam, tell us what you think about the 2006 Mel Gibson film Apocalypto, or I swear on the life of my firstborn child, you will be shot!
Okay, let's calm down.
Look at me, Adam, look at Penelope!
Adam, you have 10 seconds to answer or you face the fires of hell!
Should I set a timer?
You should not set a timer, Adam. How can we trust you to set a timer when you can't even tell us your thoughts on the 2006 Mel Gibson film Apocalypto?
Adam, if you don't tell us your opinion on the 2006 Mel Gibson film Apocalypto, I will butcher you!
Adam, hopefully coming soon.
Thank you.
Welcome back, everyone, to this important coverage on ANN, a news network. I'm Sharon Wobble Wobble.
And I'm Danielle Gerber Werber Herber. It's been a tense month leading up to the midterm elections, but the results are finally in, and it is time for the new Senate to be revealed.
Yes, it is, Danielle. Yes, it is our first announcement from the state of Missouri. The elected officials are Scott Scottingson, a 51-year-old from the Democratic Party, and Herb Bedingus, a 61-year-old from the Republican Party.
Very exciting, very exciting. A surprising win for Senator Bedingus after what happened when he visited the Capitol last January.
Yes, it was quite the controversy when those photos leaked of him vomiting on that children's choir.
I have heard that one of the boys has regained vision in his left eye, but is still working on the right.
Good to hear, good to hear. Up next, we have Utah with the election of two Democratic senators, 69-year-old Robert Smith IV and 71-year-old Smith Roberts VI.
That is very strange.
The name similarities.
No, two Democratic senators in Utah.
Yes, that is very true.
The next state to be revealed is Mississippi. For more on that, let's cut to ANN's new political analyst, Peter Papalapalooza.
Thanks for having me, guys. So these next two candidates have been widely discussed among the analyst community. On one side, we have Steve Neisman, who volunteers at children's hospitals and is both a Navy veteran and an organ donor. And on the other side, we have literally Lord Voldemort.
That is quite the matchup. Any prediction on the winner?
I mean, I feel like the choice is pretty obvious, you know.
Word that Lord Voldemort has been elected as a United States Senator.
What?
We have also just received footage of the victory speech from Alabama incumbent Senator Brett Brachioli. Let's take a look.
I don't like immigrants.
And it looks like our video feed cut out. But I'm sure Senator Brachioli gave an empowering speech on patriotism and real American values.
Yeah, that's definitely not it.
A surprising show of diversity from elected officials in Idaho today with the election of 97-year-old Republican candidate Blanco Whiteman claiming victory.
That is truly a step in the right direction.
Guys, I'm sorry. How is that diversity?
Well, Blanco Whiteman's parents immigrated from France.
Well, I didn't know if maybe we would have, like, candidates who were younger, like, African-American, Hispanic, Latino, you know, some like that? Okay. What?
You're such an idiot.
What?
What?
Oh, naive little Peter. We're in America. Listen, I know you're new here, but come on.
Well, I don't know. I figured America was ready for, like, step in the right direction. It's 2021, you know? You know, gay marriage, Barack Obama, like, female Ghostbusters.
Oh, sweet, sweet Peter. This is America. The last time we tried to take a step in the right direction, women lost a lot of rights in Texas.
Oh, I get, I don't know, I just, I'm just, I'm confused, I'm new, I don't know, this is my first time,
Classic, truly classic.
Indeed, indeed.
Well, moving on, we have just acquired the information that Montana has elected Chris Crystal Clarkson as Republican senator. Very controversial.
Why is that?
To the state of Montana, I want to emphasize that I am the senator for you. Let's bring back the incredibly unproblematic times of 1950s America.
Thank you.
Take this to Donna and she'll give you your ID photo. Next.
Hi, I'm here to get my license renewed.
Okay, you're here to get your license renewed. Let me see. Okay. Alrighty, name, DLN, birthday is today.
Thank you.
Oh, happy birthday. This is a great place to go for your birthday.
It is?
Oh, yeah. You should check out the party rooms in the back.
Wow, really?
Mm-hmm. In fact, how about I announce the birthday boy on the intercom? Take this to Shanice, and she'll give you your proof of residence.
Yes.
Excuse me?
I've thought about it, and I would like my name announced on the intercom.
Like to wish a happy birthday to number 27 in line, who is now heading over to Shanice.
Come on, you can do better than that.
Three cheers for number 27 in line. Hip, hip. Hip, hip.
Hooray.
Hip, hip.
Hooray.
That's what I thought. Next.
Oh, come on, guys. Let's sing happy birthday, okay? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. I guess everybody just forgot the words. Why don't you just show me to the party room and we'll call it even.
There is no party room.
Follow me to the party room. I've got hats. I've got noisemakers, confetti. Oh! I even have a pinata with it. Yeah, pinata.
Like I said, there's no party room. Next.
What? That's impossible. They couldn't have all filled up by now. I mean, I'm the only one who has a birthday. Nobody else has a birthday.
Oh my God, you're holding up the line.
I can do that. It's my birthday. I can do that.
No, you can't do that.
Yes, I can, you birthdayless fool. So do you know when the pizza will get here? Because I'm supposed to have some time in the party room.
Honey, I've been working here for 35 years. I know this place better than I know my own children. If there was a party room, I would know about it because I would use the room to cry.
Then where am I supposed to eat my pizza?
Honey, please go see Shanice.
Right over there.
I get it. I'm so sorry. I understand. I'm so sorry. Sorry. Yeah. There's a party room for me?
Boy, what did Brenda just tell you? There is no party room!
Then where am I supposed to meet Sally Fudds?
Who's Sally Fudds?
Tell me why Sally Fudds in my party room to serve me ice cream cake and sing me happy birthday. She's gonna wear a parakeet costume, the one where the head doesn't stay on right, and say her famous line, Flappy Birthday from Sally Fudds!
That's her catchphrase?
Yeah, she says it on birthdays. So bring her out. I'm ready to be surprised.
Brenda, I'm taking my break. And not in the party room.
So this is why everybody hates the DMV.
No, that's not why.
I'm finding a new place to celebrate my birthday next year.
Okay, so you...
Surprise! Flappy birthday from Sally's Fudds.
I think he left.
Well, he's gonna miss the special dance.
Well, if anyone wants ice cream, head back to the party room.
Thank you.
Spare change. Spare change. Anyone? Spare change.
Hey!
Spare a dollar.
No! Get back to work. Those prime boxes aren't gonna pack themselves.
Yes, sir.
Damn, girl, are you from Tennessee?
Yes.
Fancy. I have my pants on backwards and I still can't find my socks and shoes.
I lost my diamond earring touchdown. It was my grandma. She found it in a vending machine.
Guys, if we were truly fancy, we'd all be wearing Gucci boots right now. I still don't understand why Belmont wouldn't pay for those for us.
You're confused. Being fancy is a mindset, and if you don't understand that, I can't explain it to you.
Guys, I've been thinking about it, and I've decided it doesn't matter if we're fancy or not. We're the Fall Follies, and we're a family.
What we really need to realize, though, Ty, is that it doesn't matter whether or not we're fancy. What matters is that we're the Fall Follies, and we're a family, you guys.
Yeah! You know what, guys? Maddie's right. We may not be fancy, and we may not be appropriate, and we may not be funny, but we also... we may not be likable.
Hey, I guess that's why they call us the Fall Follies.
Yeah. Am I the only one that doesn't get it?
All I'm saying is we did a whole set worth of sketch comedy. That's more than these people could do. You think you can do that? No, loser.
Forget about this whole fancy thing. I mean, it's starting to not even sound like a real word. Fancy, 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 fancy. What are we doing?
You know what? Katie has a great point. I mean, you guys could probably just get rid of the word fancy on your programs if possible. I really don't know. But you know what? We're not fancy. We just aren't.
We're Follies. Yeah, yeah, we're Follies. Yeah, yeah, we're Follies.
We're Follies.
We're Follies.
Yeah, yeah.
We're Follies.
go, go.
Okay.
I don't have time.